Cross-processing. Cross-processing is a technique that is coming from film days. Sometimes they would process a certain type of film in chemicals that were intended for a different type of film. And this usually created the cross-process look. We are going to be using three different techniques to apply cross-processing to this shot now. Let's start by balancing this shot first. I'm going to look for a reference frame. This one seems good. I'm going to bring the shadows down. Gamma up. Shadows down. And I'm going to add a bit of saturation. Let's add a new nod. In this nod, I'm going to start by reducing the blue in the highlights. We do that by dragging the gain control away from blue and towards the yellow. So, the next thing I'm going to do is to drag the lift in the other direction. So I'm going to get the shadows to become more blue. And I'm going to keep on balancing highlights and shadows until I feel that this is a start of a look that I like. I'm going to even push it a bit further. Let's add a new nod. I'm going to cross the shadows again by coming to lift and just reducing the shadows. And this is starting to look better. I am going to also reduce the saturation. And I'm going to add a new nod. In the final nod, we're going to be using log mode. I'm going to repeat the same process again by balancing the highlights and the shadows just in log mode this time. And I'm going to add a final nod to cross the shadows one more time. Okay, now I'm going to right click and create a new version. We'll call this version 3. Now, let's try achieving the same look using curves now. So I'm going to come to color and reset all grades and nods. Let's go to curves and use just custom curves. I am going to start by unchecking gang custom curves. Before we start with curves, there is one more thing to know. You can click on this button down to expand curves. This will provide you with a more of a precise control over your curves. I'm going to start by bringing the shadows down and bringing the rest of the image up. Notice that by using curves, we are getting a fundamentally different look than the look we got when we used primaries. I'm going to add a new nod, expand the curves again, bring the highlights and the blue curve down. Notice that the further we push the blue down, our image is getting more yellow. Now, we're going to go to the shadows of the blue and raise the shadows up. We're going to go to the red channel and increase the contrast in the red channel by placing a pin in the middle and just increasing highlights and reducing the shadows just a bit. Let's come down and just reduce the blue more. Let's add a new nod. And just apply more contrast to the image. Okay. Now we're going to right click, local versions, and create a new version. This will be version 4. Let's reset. Now I'm going to apply the same look again with primaries, just using a different way of controlling the primaries. I'm going to start here by bringing the shadows down and increasing the midtones. Shadows down, reducing saturation a bit. And I'm going to add a new nod, just increase the saturation a bit more. Now, I'm going to come to the blue channel in gain, which controls the blue and the highlights, and just bring it down. Again, the more I push the blue down, the more yellow the image will become. I'm going to balance this by increasing the blue channel in the shadows. Let's balance it again by decreasing the blue channel in the highlights. Okay, now, let's start by increasing the red channel in the highlights now, and reducing the red channel in the shadows. Yeah, balancing it again with the highlight. And adding a new nod, adding more contrast. Right-click, local versions, create a new version, and this will be version 5. Now, in order to compare the three different methods that we used to achieve the cross-processing look, I'm going to right-click on the screen, split screen, on and off. And now we're presented with the three different versions. Notice that using the curves provided us with a more of a harsh look. Of course, we can always tweak curves to make this one look like the other ones, but this is just to demonstrate how different tools will actually make you achieve different results.